Now let's assume an irreversible reaction that A plus B goes to products, and the rate of reaction or kinetic equation can be written as minus R of A is equal to K of A C A raised to power alpha C of B raised to power beta, where alpha and beta are the respective orders for these species, and alpha plus beta will give the overall order of the reaction. Now we need to perform the two experiments over here. Like if you say that excess A experiment, if you remember our example number 5.1, where we had said that water is in excess. So once it is in excess, we had taken it out from the kinetic equation, or we had said that it is the pseudo first order system. So we have to make the second order system as a pseudo first order by making sure that the concentration of one of the species is in excess. So excess A experiment means that the CA remains unchanged. Accordingly, minus RA is equal to K of A, C raised to power alpha, C B raised to power beta. C of A remains unchanged. It means that it will be equal to CA naught. So K of A, CA naught will become as K double prime, which means that it is now a pseudo first order system. And now we can determine the value of beta and K double prime over here. In the same way, we can carry out excess B experiment that C of B remains unchanged during the course of the reaction. Accordingly, that CB will become equal to CB naught, that KA CB naught will become K prime, accordingly K prime CA raised to power alpha. And now we can determine the value of alpha and K prime. Once alpha and beta are determined, KA can be calculated from the measurement of minus RA. How we can calculate KA? Minus RA over CA raised to power alpha, CB raised to power beta. We have calculated alpha and beta over here. We know already know the concentration, the rate of reaction will be known, so we can calculate the value of K from that system. So that is the method of excess, where we have to make sure that we have to make it a first order system, or we can say simply a pseudo first order system.